Hello friends, I'm back with another video on the poem Daffodils. Dear friends, this poem is composed by William Wordsworth, who was the pioneer of romantic movement or the romanticism, or in other words we can say romantic revival in the English literature. As soon as he published the lyrical ballad in 1798, it was the announcement of romantic literature or the romantic movement in English literature. Dear friends, this poem Daffodils is one of the best example that takes us in the company of nature, or that leads us to think about the concept of nature as described by William Wordsworth in this poem. So let us see some details or the biographical sketch about the William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was born on 7th April 1770 at Cockermouth in Lake District. In 1843, he became the poet laureate after the death of Robert Southey, who was his close friend. William Wordsworth was heavily influenced by the French Revolution that happened in 1789, which was at its peak at this time in France, where he found or learned the concept of democracy or the democratic values, that is liberty, fraternity and equality. He pioneered the romantic poetry in English literature, and with the publication of Lyrical Ballad in 1798 in collaboration with St. Coleridge, he announced that the beginning of romantic revival in English poetry. He is also known as the Lake Poet, because he lived, or his house was set or situated at Lake District. In English literature, lake poets is a term that is very popular. Among the lake poets, that includes William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge and Robert Southey were the early romantics in English literature. And this great figure, who lived during the Queen Victoria, died on 23rd April 1850 at the age of 80. Now let us see some backgrounds about this poem. This background, or you can say this poem Daffodils, is an outcome of his visit with his sister Dorothy when they visited the Clarkson at Usmere. When they were coming back to Grasmere, they saw a large number of golden daffodils. Golden means yellow colored daffodils growing on the bank of Lake Illswater in Lake District. And they were surprised to see, or they were surprised to have such kind of beauty of golden daffodils. And they were very much mesmerized from the beauty of these daffodils. And when they saw the dancing and the fluttering and the moving, the flowers of daffodils, he was very much inspired, and he started writing a poetry in under the title Daffodils. Basically, Wordsworth composed this poem in 1804, and later on this poem published in 1807. It is says that William Wordsworth has revised this poem in 1852. So now, dear student, let us see and understand the poem Daffodils. In the stanza first, he says, "I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over wells and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze." Now let us see the lines one by one. In the very opening line of this poem, the poet William Wordsworth says, "I wandered lonely as a cloud, ki main aise hi badalon ki tarah akela ghoomta tha, roaming karta tha ya ghoom raha tha. I wandered, my mind, With the help of his imagination, he is roaming in the sky like a cloud, he says. And with the help of his imagination, he is just pointing out, or he is just recollecting the experiences, or the beauty, or the mesmerizing, you know, colors of daffodils. And he writes like this: I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over wells and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of a golden daffodils. Golden means yellow color. It was yellow. The word yellow was added in 1804, but later on, when William Wordsworth has revised this poem, he added the word, or he replaced the golden word to yellow. And beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. In the first stanza, he is using various figure of speeches also. In the opening line, he says he compares his loneliness to a cloud. He used the word lonely as a cloud that floats, means his imagination is floating like a cloud over the hills. And when he saw the group or the bunch of golden daffodils, he considered that it is like a crowd. So another figure of speech, that is hyperbole, that he has used in this third line. The poet is wandering alone from one place to another like a cloud, which flies over the valleys and hills with the flow of his minds and with the flow of wind, he says. And suddenly, the poet sees a large number of golden daffodils in front of his eyes. And these daffodils are growing close to the lake, under the trees, beneath the trees, that he says. Beside the lake and beneath the trees, and a light breeze, a pleasant air that is blowing and making these daffodils dancing or dance and flutter with him. Now see, my dear student, he has used William Shakespeare ne ek dancing ye jo word hai, ye jo personified kiya hai, jo human क्या क्वालिटीज है जो फ्लावर को एट्रीब्यूट की है, जो फ्लावर है गोल्डन डैफोडिल्स, वो हमारी तरह आदमी के तरह, ह्यूमन बीइंग्स की तरह डांस करता है, ऐसे वो बोलता है. किस पे? एक जो बहने वाली हवा है, जो ब्रीज है, जो विंड है, उसके ऊपर वो डांस और फ्लटरिंग कर रही है. मतलब आपको समझ में आ गया होगा कि वो कंसिडर करता है कि मैं एक बादलों की तरह घूमता हूं एक विल्स और वैलीज में, वहां पे मैंने एक ऐसा गोल्डन डैफोडिल्स का ग्रुप देखा जो किसी पॉन्ड्स के या लेक के बाजू में था, और वो देखते समय मुझे इतना आनंद लगा या आनंद मिला जो एक डांस कर रहे थे या फिर फ्लटरिंग भी कर रहे थे, ऐसे भी हम यहाँ पे बोल सकते हैं. चलो फिर इन द सेकंड स्टांजा पे जाते हैं. विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेम कंसेप्ट ऑफ डैफोडिल्स एंड ही कंटिन्यूज इन द ओपनिंग लाइन ऑफ द सेकंड स्टांजा. आल्सो ही हैज यूज्ड द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच सिमिली एंड ही सेज कंटिन्यूस एज द स्टार्स दैट शाइन. जो गोल्डन डैफोडिल्स है वो कैसे है? स्टार्स के जो चमचम जो ट्विंकलिंग स्टार है स्काई में, उनकी तरह चमकते हैं. और एंड ट्विंकल ऑन द मिल्की वे, जो रात के समय जो मून होता है उसका जो लाइट होता है. इन द मून लाइट द वे द पाथवे इज शाइनिंग इज ग्लिटरिंग लाइक अ ट्विंकलिंग स्टार्स, राइट? एंड इट लुक्स लाइक अ मिल्की वे, ही सेज. और वो कहता है कि दे स्ट्रेच इन नेवर एंडिंग लाइन. उस वो जो रात के अंधेरे में वो जो एक रास्ता जो दिखता है, वो उसको ऐसे जैसे कोई रास्ते पे रिबन के जैसे लगता है, राइट? और वो बोलता है कि अलोंग द मार्जिन ऑफ द बे 10,000 सॉ आई एट अ ग्लांस टोजिंग देयर हेड इन स्प्राइटली डांस. यार इस स्टांजा में आपको पता चलेगा दोस्तों, द पोएट विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ इज सेइंग दैट The daffodils looks like the stars that shines and twinkle in the Milky Way. The daffodils are spreading over a very large area along the margin of a bay, and they are in an excessively huge quantity, you can say. And all these daffodils are dancing happily in the wind. So the same concept, the last line of the first stanza, fluttering and dancing on the pleasant breeze, the last line of the second stanza is also depicts the dance of the golden daffodils, as we have seen in this. And sprightly means with full energy, with full force, with great energy, he says. So in this stanza also, William's Wordsworth is describing the beauty of golden daffodils, as we have seen. Now come to third stanza. In the third stanza, the poet tells us that the waves beside them dance. The waves matlab lehre jo tarange jisko bolte hain, the waves beside them dance, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. A poet could not but be a gay in such a jocund company. I gaze and gaze, but little thought but wealth the show to me had brought, he says. अभी देखिए इस स्टांजा में वो क्या बोलता होगा. इस स्टांजा में द पोएट सेज दैट द वेव्स इन द लेक बिसाइड दीज डैफोडिल्स आर आल्सो डांसिंग इन द वेव्स और इन द विंड्स इन द ब्रीज, बट इन कंपैरिजन टू डैफोडिल्स द वेव्स आर नॉट ब्यूटीफुल एज ब्यूटीफुल एज एंड अट्रैक्टिव टू. मीन्स द वेव्स आर गोइंग बिसाइड दैट लेक, बट द डांसिंग इमेज ऑफ दैट daffodils is more pleasant, is more beautiful, is more precious to William Wordsworth. As he was a nature poet, he is focusing on the beauty of that flower too. Then he continues and says, watching, miss, as he watched the beauty of that beautiful scene, beautiful golden daffodils, the poet feels very happy in his mind, in his heart. The poet continues to look at the daffodils, and he prizes the scene greatly.
In stanza number 4,
so that is why he has used the word and says to show
for oft
that
when I
flowers are when very
on
much
my
or
couch
very,
I lie
very meaningful
for
in
oft
the life of
when I am William
when
Wordsworth,
my on
as
my
he says,
couch I lie.
Then he continues
in a vacant
and
or pensive
tells
mood,
us that the
in a such a
jocund
company,
jocund
means
that
very cheerful
eye,
in the company of
which
nature,
in the
every man,
solitude,
every human being feels
and
very
then
happy,
my heart with
and
pleasure
like
feel
all these
and
people,
dances
even with
William
Wordsworth is also
now,
very happy.
My dear student,
and
you will understand the meaning,
his
very
joy
easily
in the form of
the,
words.
Here the poet says that ki whenever he lies down on the bed, either thinking
now
about anything or
stanza
not thinking,
four,
the image of daffodils flash upon his imagination. And it usually happen only when the poet is all alone. Means the spontaneous overflow or the spontaneous joy that is he is feeling here, that is he experienced or that he has experienced in a tranquility, in a solitude, in a loneliness. Right? And that is a bliss, that is the extreme happiness that he collected, that he had enjoyed in a solitude, he says. And the images of daffodils have a magical effect on the poet. These images fills the very heart of the poet with pleasure. And here William Wordsworth also feels like dancing with the daffodils. Right? So this is a very simple and the most popular, which is prescribed in various syllables at school, at colleges, in colleges. Syllabus or curriculum. So this is how we can understand the poem. Then we can find some poetic devices in this poem also. As I have already said in the first stanza, the opening line of the sentence or a stanza, I wandered lonely as a cloud. The word as that shows the figure of speech, simile is used. In the second stanza also, the first line of the second stanza, that is continues as the stars that shine, this line has a simile. Then he has used various personification, fluttering and dancing. The word dancing is a human quality, or we, if human, can dance. But he says that flower, that golden daffodils are dancing in the breeze, in the wind, right? So this is one of the best example of personification. Then he has says, or he has used the words that excited the beauty, or that increased the beauty of golden daffodils, where he says, when all at once I saw a crowd, this is an example of hyperbole or the exaggeration. And another important figure of speech that is used by William Wordsworth, that is alliteration. What is alliteration? Alliteration is a repetition of the consonant sound, right? Alliteration is a repetition of the consonant sound in the beginning of a word or in the successive syllable. So here you can find beside, beneath. The alphabet, or you can say the letter B, is repeated in the same line. Beside the lake, beneath the trees. And in the last line, last stanza, you can find this line also. And dances with the daffodils. So these four poetic devices are used by the William Wordsworth in this poem to increase the beauty of these daffodils also. Dear friends, here the poet is very alone, and having mature in his mind, he is enjoying the company of nature in his mind and wandering from one place to another place with the help of his mind or with the help of his imagination, right? And he is thinking that he is not busy or being busy. He is just lying on the couch. Lying on the couch means on his bed, and he is just imagining. He is just recollecting the beauties of the flowers that is in yellow color with the help of his imagination or his memory, right? So this is how we can understand the poem. I hope, my dear student, you will love this poem when you read personally. If you are listening me for the first time on this YouTube channel, Let's Learn to Shine, you can hit the button, subscribe button, and you will get the latest notification of the uploaded video in the coming future.